The Overstory is a 2018 novel by the American author Richard Powers. If you're one of those people, as I am, who worries that avoidable climate change has brought humanity to the brink of disaster, then this may be one of the most important novels of all time. In that case, you would evaluate novels not on their formal literary merits, although those of the Overstory are highly significant, but on their capacity to spur readers to action, or at least convince them that action, even relatively extreme action such as living in a tree to prevent it being felled, is not only reasonable, but right. I mentioned living in a tree simply because that's what several of the characters in the Overstory do. Along the way, they learn a lot about themselves and about trees generally. The tree in question, by the way, is hundreds of years old. But of course, spoiler alert, the lumberjacks and their bosses, the big businessmen, have their way in the end. I won't spend a long time here explaining what a great read the Overstory is. I probably don't have to. It was shortlisted for the Man Booker in 2018, and it won the Pulitzer Prize for Fiction the following year. The writing's outstanding, the characters are engaging and utterly plausible. But what's more important to point out is its solid grounding in the science of trees. One of the novel's central characters was inspired by a real-life Canadian scientist called Suzanne Simard. I don't think I'm oversimplifying things when I say that Simard proved, for the first time, what no one since ancient times had considered possible, that trees actually communicate with each other. She didn't go so far as to suggest that trees actually think. That would be a much bigger claim. But lots of philosophers would say that communication is inseparable from language, which is inseparable from thought. Just an idea. For anyone who's at all interested in the science behind the Overstory, two books are probably essential reading. Colin Tudge's 2005 The Secret Life of Trees and Peter Volabon's 2015 The Hidden Life of Trees. The next time some speculative builder tells you he or she just has to cut down that 200-year-old oak tree because it's diseased, I hope you'll have read this book.